welcome to the Making Life Changes channel. We're up early this morning out here in the garden making up some best soil you'll ever use for your garden, your raised beds, if you put in pots, whatever you're doing, this gardening mixture mix here that we're making up will absolutely save you in time of watering, keep pests out, weeds, everything, particularly if you're using raised beds and you cover the bottom of it with fabric or you're using pots, weeds won't even get in because what we're using here is called Mel's Mix. Now, Mel's Mix has been used for a very long time. Mel Bartholomew was the creator and inventor of square foot gardening. And he developed a type of soil that absolutely is wonderful. It has all the nutrients that pretty much every plant in your garden will need. And you really have no maintenance with this particular type of soil. So we're making it up this morning, and I want to share with you, it's made out of three different components. It's made out of compost that you make in your own compost bin, or you can buy at some local nurseries. We make our own here at Making Life Changes, and we'll do a video on it, show you how to make it, but it's basically made out of table scraps. It's made out of paper, different renewable that we put into it, and it decomposes over a certain amount of time, and we make just wonderful, rich nutrients. This is the heart of the mix because it has all the energy, all the vitamins and everything that the plant needs. And then right here, we have vermiculite, which is basically a component that holds in moisture really, really well. It's very neutral. It's also very similar to some other things out there like perlite, but this is a lot better. And this is what you need for your plants to grow and thrive. It's going to give the roots enough space to get air and to grow through the soil. It's very loose, as you can see. When you're out here, you definitely want a mask because if it's windy, this stuff can blow around. You don't want to really be breathing it in, so have a mask and tools. Put it on a tarp as we're doing here. Maybe a rake, a shovel, or something to mix it all with. Now, the third and final ingredient that I have here, this is peat moss. This is incredibly great organic material. It really takes a very, very long time out in the natural world for peat moss to be made. And peat moss is not a renewable resource, so we're running out of peat moss around the planet. Most of the peat moss here in North America comes from Canada. There's other places that we get it. So use it very sparingly, use it. But once you put this and the peat moss and the vermiculite garden, you never have to replace them again. They stay in there for very, very, very long time. The only thing that you have to put back into your garden every three months would be compost. You always want to add new rich compost to it. Now the formula to make this up is one 5-gallon bucket per volume. So it's not by weight, it's by volume. So you have to break down the peat moss because it comes from your local stores. You can get it, your local hardware stores sometimes will carry it, some nurseries, and don't buy the small bags. The small bags are very expensive. You want to get the ones that are 3 and 4 cubic foot. They're going to save you a bunch of money. I think I got 4 cubic foot for about $10.81 at my local hardware store. Way better than the little bags that are like $4 for just a few quarts. You don't want to go that route. Same with this. If you buy the bigger, the better. It's going to save you money in the long run. And then you want to break it down because it comes in a big blocks. And just break it with your hands, or if you got a little tool out there you can break it with, that's fine. And then fill up your buckets with it, not press it down, just fill it up to where it's by volume, and then dump them together and then just mix them. So that's what we're gonna do here in a minute. We'll pause the video, we're gonna mix everything up, and then you'll see how it looks when it's together. And also, if you got a windy day, you can take a hose, and while you're mixing it, you can just kind of spray everything down just lightly so it kind of holds it together. We don't really have much wind this morning, so we're in good shape. Okay, here we are, we're back. We just actually took the tarp and moved it from left to right, left to right. Debbie was on one side, I was on the other. We just kind of mixed it for a few minutes, and you see, this is what we end up with. This is Mel's Mix at its finest. You see how loose the soil is? Everything just kind of falls apart, but when it holds moisture and water, you can't overwater it. So when you water it, when it has too much water, it's gonna fill up to the point just like a sponge. then it's actually going to just release the rest of the water. So it's really great, keeps plants from being overwatered and underwatered. So it's great moisture control, has all the nutrients that it needs. And also I kind of went through, if you see some big sticks and stuff left over from your compost bin, you can just throw them out and put them back into your compost bin and let them break down a little bit further. All right, if this video has helped you, please subscribe, click like on our video, or share this with your social media group. If you have any questions, put it down below. We'll be sure to answer them. And also check out our other videos here on our YouTube channel. And also, you know, growing and gardening is part of God's Word. I mean, it's a way that we get closer to Him and understand what it is to care and take care and manage things. So we got a lot of great videos at our parent website at makinglifechanges.org. So if you like to check out different things spiritually, physically, and financially, go over there and take a look at our other website as well. All right, thanks so much. We're making life changes, and you can too.